And Maria's going to stand next to me because she's going to look at me.
A career in law was all Cinderella had dreamt of since giving up her dreams of being a nurse, a nun, a ballet dancer, an international skier, and Mary Poppins.
The audience is here, and then it's all masked off, so you can't see backstage. So they can enter here, like this, or they can enter from the sides. And then all of the action happens here with the dancers. And then there are three steps of chorus, all in black tie. What are you thinking?
I was just thinking, what am I thinking?
And I was wondering what you might be thinking.
Here you really want to be getting to 2 foot, right? That would be 1 foot 6, wouldn't it? We've got...
If Marty does her solo verse, that is quite a static thing. We don't have to worry about that.
Brilliant. I think it entertains people, brings people together. This market's fantastic because it has a community anyway, a community feel. And they do a lot of shows and things that are very specific to the area.
Then goes into, and by the end of the, what we want is the desk and her sitting at the desk all keen eyes, and then the whole world will talk around her. With Marty and the rest of the dancers, and then an instrumental to get her into the office.
So the idea behind this project was to do something which is short term in terms of rehearsal. So all we had was a weekly chorus rehearsal and a weekly dance rehearsal. And then we put everything together in one Sunday rehearsal, and then the show was on.
It's been really challenging. The journey's been great. It's been great working with everyone, getting to know everyone, but it's been difficult.
Well, it all starts with a concept, a brilliant choreographer, Maria, a brilliant director, Natasha, a group of fantastic dancers, very committed dancers, and you start off with an idea and it just develops and it just grows.
It seemed like the show was a very, very long way from coming together, and probably only on Sunday, about 4 days before the show, did it actually come together. That's when we had the singers and the dancers and the band and Nat and Howard and everyone, and then it started coming together.
Maria and I chose most of the songs that were going to be choreographed together, and then we went through, we had, I suppose, maybe a list of about 20 songs, and then we went through with Howard what was most achievable for the choir, and then I planned which number would go after which number, so I did the order of the songs around a basic Cinderella story, which I then wrote the script for after she choreographed the dance, so it was in relation to the dance she was doing.
We practiced at lunchtime twice a week, just in the run-up to this performance, but every time we're practicing we actually end up going back to our desks, and the few of us, a bunch of us are in the choir from my department, and we end up singing the songs as we go back along, and even on conference calls we're sometimes humming the tunes. Sometimes when we're even out as a group together as friends, we ended up singing the songs, finding them on YouTube and singing along. So, yes, I would just say it's become like a very big part of our lives as the weeks have gone on. Same firm, it's quite a big office, and it's really good that we actually get to know people that work in different departments, and actually people that aren't Fioraners as such. So we have people from the security room, we have people from document production, we have people from HR, so it's really good in marketing, it's really good at unifying the firm.
It's a great way of engaging lots of different groups of people, bringing them all together. It's a great team building project.
Everybody together, so everyone can come together and enjoy song and dance, and all the music is very inspirational. So it's just really about bringing a community together for a good cause.
Production we've put on place. I think it's we've had quite a lot of success, from Gilbert Sullivan operettas to going to Glyndebourne to perform in the Magic Flute. We also put on Carmen at the Sadler's Wells, and we put on most recently Oklahoma at the Holland Park Centre there. So we've had a really good experience, and performing here in Spitalfields is really good fun. So it's been great fun for everybody.
It seems quite fast.
I think we could sing
that.
Having the opportunity to do something like this in a law firm, where work can be pretty mundane, 9 to 5, is a good thing to express that and to get in touch with your creative side.
It's really important. It's really nice to get away from the desk for a bit and do something fun. And having rehearsals at lunchtime, it's almost like having a bit of a workout. So I find it's very important. It's one of my favourite things about my job, actually.
It's not just for lawyers, but lawyers are probably a good example of people who work very, very hard. A lot of the time in isolation, maybe. Suddenly now, they're working with members from all over the firm, up top to bottom, and having a great time.
In this, create characters for yourself. Be the grumpy person on the way to work, the late person on the way to work, the person who, you know, forgot their tune cast on the way to work and can't find any cash. Whatever little story you want to give yourself that gives you a bit of the drive as you're getting to your final position.
Because some of them could have chosen to be performers if they'd wanted to, but they decided to do something that was more lucrative.
moment for them to go away from their desk, go away from the seriousness, go away from the pressure of work, and do something not only for themselves in terms of an achievement of either the singing or the dancing, but more importantly, knowing that they're doing it for charity.
Alan Overy not only provides us with lawyers to act as advisors to our clients, but also provides corporate sponsorship, which helps fund the operation of our legal advice centre. Tonight's event was a way for Alan Overy to give us an opportunity to raise more funds to go towards supporting the work we do in the local community.
It was one of Alan Overy's biggest projects. I think it brought in more money than any other deal this year, so we're very excited.
We just wanted to say an enormous thank you to Alan and Overy and LexisNexis for tonight. It was really good fun, so many people and lots of donation for our cause.
We just need to be looking at all of those rich, handsome, young men that you can marry.
Working with lawyers, what can I say?